Good morning, children. So this is a unit about electricity. So in the unit la nama basic things la paatham. So how the electricity will acquire. So when we are saying the electricity is flowing from one point to another one point, and also we need conductor for that. So we are clear about that. In conductor, why we are calling that as conductor? It allows the charges to flow. And the conductor la electrons are ready to move. The electrons are ready to move from one point to another one point. There are more free electrons. So that's why it is conducting electricity. Illa ma previous class la paathom. Then exchange of electrons later discuss panniitom. And about atom we discussed in last class. And today we will start from the similar effect from figure 5.4 and 5.5. In 5.4, this figure explains the glass rod is rubbing with the silk cloth. At the time, the glass rod will lose some electrons to the silk cloth. So, electrons glass rod la remove agudhu appadina, it will become positive charge. Idhu na last class la sonna. Every atom are neutral. So, when it will become positive? When it losing electrons. That same thing is happening here. Glass rod is losing some electrons. It moves to silk cloth. So now the silk cloth is acquired with a negative charge and glass rod will become positive. So this transfer of electrons bring the glass rod as positive. The same thing is explained in next representation. And ebonite rod rubbing with the fur cloth, and here this fur will lose some electrons to ebonite. Now ebonite will become negatively charged because it acquires some electrons. Same time the fur become a positive after losing some electrons. So that is explained in this figure 5.5. So when we are rubbing from one material, some electrons will transfer to next one. So it loses. Another one is gains. The gained material, which is called as negative, it will become negative. And which one losing the electrons, it will become positively charged. So that is more clear from this these two figures. And next, do you know? So here say the glass rod having positively charge, if it bring to another one glass rod, means the another one glass rod is also positive, then positive is moving towards another one positive, definitely it will be repelled to each other. Okay, suppose we are doing the same experiment in another one way, the positively glass rod brought close to the negatively ebonite rod, means these two will be attracted to each other. So we can say the same charges will repulse and opposite charges will get attracted. Okay, and now we'll move to the next topic, transfer by conduction. So the topic number 5.3.2 is the topic about transfer by conduction. And here this topic starts with small activity. We are taking the small sheet of paper. We are converting to the cylinder. So one end of the cylinder paper is tying with the silk thread. And we are hanging that on a stand. Now take a ebonite rod. And it is charged by the rubbing method with the woolen. So bring the ebonite near the paper. The cylinder will attract by the rod. If you touch the paper cylinder, by the charged you will see the paper cylinder repelling the rod. Can you say the reason? Because of the opposite charges. So when the ebonite rod is rubbed with the woolen, electrons from the woolen flow is transferred to the ebonite. This ebonite will become what? Negative. Now ebonite is negative charge. So when it is brought near to the cylinder, negative charges in the rod attracted by the positive in the cylinder. So opposite charges are attracted. When the cylinder is touched by the rod, some negative charges are transferred to the paper, and now the negative charges in the rod repelled with negative to the cylinder. So the concept is same charges always repels to each other, and opposite charges will attract. And by touching method, so two materials are physically contacted here. After contact, the charges is transferred from one material to another. Like silk is rubbing with the glass and ebonite is rubbing with the fur. Now the charges are transferred. So this transfer of charges are called as, the method is called as transfer by contacting. Okay, there is a physical contacting. So that's why this method is called as conduction. So what is that? This is called as conduction. And in this we having, do you know? In this do you know, we can say the materials which allow the electric charges are called as conductors. And which materials will not allow the flow of electrons, that is called as insulators or non-conductors. An example for conductors, we can say human body, then iron, gold, copper, silver, etc. For insulator or non-conductor, we can say the examples rubber, glass, stone, etc. So these examples are the for conductors and non-conductors. Okay, this is by the method of conduction. And next is induction. So here we will discuss the charges are flowing from one material to another material by the method of induction. So in this induction, there is no direct transfer like a previous one. Okay, here we are adapting with some other method. How is that method? We can understand from this figure. Okay, and see the first one. In first one, we having the two things, two materials. One is neutral body and next one is charged body with the negative charges. When neutral body and charged body are very close to each other, see here it is not contacting directly. We are bringing the charged body near to the neutral body. Neutral body does not have any axis of charges, having the equal with both positive and negative. We are bringing the negatively charged body near to the neutral body. At the time, from the charged body, some electrons will repelled to next end of the neutral body. Why it is going to next end is because this charged body having negative, some electrons are coming out. It can't stay here because these two will be repelled. Because of the repulsion, it accumulated in the next end of the neutral body. And here, due to the deficiency, only electrons are available in this material. And due to this deficiency, these accumulated electrons will create some positive because of deficiency. So equal number of positive charges will be created there, and these positive charges are near to the negative because of the attraction. Okay, and now the next end of the neutral is connected to the ground connection. So ground connection, that is nothing but earthing. In upcoming topic, we'll discuss about that. When we are connecting with the ground connection, the charges will flow into the earth. Now only positive charges will be there in this neutral. And now see, we produced opposite charges in the neutral one without any direct contact. This is the method is called as induction. So here we transfer the charge from charged metal into neutral metal. So this is called as, this method is called as transfer of charges by induction. Okay. And next, flow of charges. Next topic is flow of charges. Here we will see how the charges are flowing. The general concept for flow of charges is, நம்ம எல்லா இடத்துலையும் யூஸ் பண்ணுறதுலையும் ஜென்ரல் கான்செப்ட் என்ன அப்படின்னா, எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் வில் ஃப்ளோ ஃப்ரம் லோ பொட்டென்ஷியல். த எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் ஆர் ப்ரொடியூஸ்டு ஃப்ரம் லோ பொட்டென்ஷியல். இட் இஸ் ஃப்ளோயிங் நவ் ஃப்ரம் லோ பொட்டென்ஷியல் டு ஹை பொட்டென்ஷியல். ஸோ ஹை பொட்டென்ஷியல் இஸ் வாட் பாசிட்டிவ். ஏன்னா இப்போ நம்ம அந்த கான்செப்டை படித்தோம், ஆப்போசிட் சார்ஜஸ் வில் பி அட்ராக்டட் அண்ட் சேம் சார்ஜஸ் வில் ரிப்பல்ட். That is the concept. All the electrons are flowing towards the high potential. It produces electric current. Okay. And for that, here we having on figure figure 5.6. This is also one method for transfer of charges. Here green color ball indicating that metal indicating lower potential. This brown one is higher potential. When these two balls, these two charged metal balls are connected with the wire, some connecting material. This conducting material is connected between the low potential and high potential. So automatically the electrons will flow from lower potential to high potential until the charge will get neutralized. Now the electric current is flowing. So this is the method is called as transfer. So high potential is nothing but high voltage, and low potential is nothing but low voltage, and this low and high voltage will create some electric current by moving the charges from low to high potential. Okay, and ipo idu we are more clear about that. Adhavadhu electrons positive plate ku high potential ku move aagumbodhu produce aagura electric current endra namakku nallave theriyum. So electrons flow aana mattum dhaan electric current produce aagum. Na last class la sonna nama veetla power cut aayiruchuna we should not say current illa, current cut aayiruchu appdi sollakoodadhu. It should be called as power. Okay, ena verum potential mattum vechikittu we can't use any appliances. They mari verum current mattum vechikittu we can't use any appliances. So combiningly we are using that combination is called as power. Okay, so power is nothing but what? Voltage into current. So power enna solrom voltage yum current yum combine pandratha we are saying as power. Adu eppo delivery aagum appadina the electrons flowing from low voltage to high voltage in the time only it will happens. Okay, so first la or 200 300 years back la enna nenchirundanga na the electricity is nothing but electricity indra or topic vandhilirundhe. Okay, not 200 back years electricity appdin or word nam start panadhilirundhe what they felt is they thought the moving positive charges only will producing electric current. The moving charges only will producing electric current அப்படின்ற மாதிரி they thought, but it is wrong. It is wrong. எது மூவ் ஆன மட்டும் எலக்ட்ரிக் கரண்ட் ப்ரொடியூஸ் ஆகும் அப்படின்னா வென் த எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் ஆர் ஃப்ளோயிங் தென் உள்ள எலக்ட்ரிக் கரண்ட் வில் ப்ரொடியூஸ். அட் தி சேம் டைம் இன்னொரு கான்செப்ட் என்ன அப்படின்னா the positive charges also responsible for current inside the cell or battery. So that is called as conventional. Okay, and this is called as conventional current. And next topic is electroscope, and this is the electroscope. This is called a scientific instrument. It is used to detect the presence of electric charges. So what is the use of this? It is used to detect the presence of electric charges on a body. In year 1600, British physicist William Gilbert invented the first electroscope. It is the first electrical instrument. There are two types of electroscopes. One is pithball electroscope. Next is gold leaf electroscope. So what are the two types? Pithball electroscope, then gold leaf electroscope. An electroscope made out of conducting materials, generally metal. See, it works on the principle like charges repels each other. This is the principle we are using. So what is the principle we are using in this electroscope? Like charges repels each other. Okay, and here we are using metal rod that extends upward, and two ends. One end is connected with the knob, metal knob, and next end is connected with the two balls. Okay, and extend upwards and ends in a knob at the end. The first electroscope developed in this case we can use golden leaf also. That we'll discuss in next topic. First electroscope was developed in the year of 1600. William Gilbert was called a bursorium, and attracted the charged bodies brought near. Okay, so when we are bringing the charged body near to the knob, see here there are two leaves at bottom, figure 5.7. when we are bringing the charged body near to the knob, so at that time this charged body will induce some charges in the farther end. So what we discussed in transfer by induction. Upon it is a charged body in a create agum, opposite charges will be there. Ipo keela rendu leaves um paarenga, it is negative, no, then these two will be repelled to each other. So same concept we can explain when we are bringing the positive plate near to the knob. This positive plate is creating the negative charges near to that knob because in the method of induction. Induction nama discuss pannitom la, and see here positive and negative, and these two are positive, then it will repels once again. So when these two leaves or these two metals are repel, we can say some charges are there. So in the charged plate of valley edutona, there is no repulsion, and now the leaves will become as usual position. Okay, this is the working of this electroscope, and here the expression for gold leaf electroscope. And this gold leaf electroscope is explaining the working of this and how we can find out whether the charges are present or not. And this electroscope was developed by the scientist in the year of 1787, by a British scientist named Abraham Bennett. So gold and silver are used in this electroscope because they are best conductors in electric current. So ninga udane yosikalam. ஏன் நம்ம வீட்டு ஒயர்லாம் காப்பர் யூஸ் பண்ணுறோம், இல்லை கோல்டு சில்வர் யூஸ் பண்ணலாம் அப்படின்னா, நம்ம கோல்டு சில்வர் யூஸ் பண்ணால் எவனாவது கட் பண்ணி தூக்கிட்டு ஓடிடுவான். ஓகே, அண்ட் ஆல்சோ இட் இஸ் மோர் காஸ்ட்லி. ஸோ தட்ஸ் வி ஆர் யூஸிங் காப்பர். காப்பர் பார்த்தோன்னா லெஸ் இட் இஸ் சீப்பாக, அண்ட் யாரும் அது நம்ம ரோட்டில் அந்த ஒயர் போட்டாலும் யாரும் தொடவே மாட்டான். பட் கோல்டு ஒயரை வாங்கி நம்ம ரோட்டில் போட்டிருந்தோன்னா அவ்வளோதான், தூக்கிட்டு போயிடுவான். ஸோ தட்ஸ் வி ஆர் யூஸிங் காப்பர் ஹியர். அண்ட் தென் வி வில் சீ த ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் ஆஃப் எலக்ட்ரோஸ்கோப். திஸ் எலக்ட்ரோஸ்கோப் இஸ் மேட் பை கிளாஸ் ஜார். It is made by what? Glass jar. There is a brass. It is inserted in this electroscope, and the two ends of the brass is connected with the this rod is called as brass rod. The bottom end of this brass rod is connected with the two leaves, and top it is connected with the knob. When the brass disc is electroscope touched by the charged object, the electric charge get transferred, the gold leaf will repel to each other. Okay, so when we are bringing the positive charge up in the pole, so at bottom by the method of induction, some opposite charges will be, others will produces at the top of the knob, and same charges enna metal la enna material kondu varumo adhe same charges will produce at the golden leaves. Now these two will be repel to each other. Then we can find out some charges are present in that material. If that material, that broad material is neutral, then it won't happen. And now, so the transfer of charges from one object to another in this method is called as charging. In case of gold leaves, charge is transferred through brass rods. When we have taken out that charged material, now the repulsion between the two gold leaves, once again it reached the same base position. This is called as discharging. So when we are touching, when we are bringing the charged material near to that knob, it is called as charging. So when we are taken away from that knob, it is called as discharging. Okay, so that's why the gold leaves would also discharge when somebody touches the brass rods with a bare hands, because we having some charges. Okay, and this is about electric charge, electric discharge. And next one is lightning and thunder. So before discussing about lightning and thunder, we'll see on activity number 4. So here it is given, the knob is given that is attached to the door, which is called as some kind of metal. We are rubbing our foot on carpet floor, then we are touching the knob, means we will feel some shock. So because of opposite, so when we are rubbing with the carpet floor and we are getting charges in our body, when we are touching the metal, some discharge will happens here. The discharge is due to the opposite charge. The electrons are flowing from low potential to high potential. So this is happening in faster rate, in a fraction of a second. This shock is called as the movement of charges from one point to another one point. So we are feeling like a shocking. So the same thing is happening in the lightning also. So we know, or we should know, the lightning and thundering should happen at the same time. But we can see the lightning at first, sound will be later. Then over time produce ஆகும். ஆனால் நம்ம லைட்னிங் ஃபஸ்ட்டு பார்ப்போம், அதுக்கப்புறம் தான் சவுண்டை கேட்க முடியும். ஏன் அப்படின்னா, லைட் இஸ் ட்ராவலிங் மோர் ஃபாஸ்டர் தென் சவுண்ட். தட் இஸ் அ ரீசன். ஓகே. அண்ட் டியூரிங் த ரெய்னி டைம், ஸோ மோர் வாட்டர் ட்ராப்ஸ் வில் பி தேர் இன் கிளவுட், அண்ட் வாட்டர் ட்ராப்ஸ் வில் மூவ் ஹியர் அண்ட் தேர். ஸோ இந்த ஐஸ் கிறிஸ்டல் வில் பிளேஸ் இன் அப்வர்ட், இட் இஸ் கண்டெய்னிங் த பாசிட்டிவ் சார்ஜ், and water drops will gain negative charges, and because of the induction method, an upper part of the cloud is positive and lower part of the cloud will become what? Negative. So when they come in contact, these two charges are come in contact with the help of ice drops and water drops, there is a production of lightning. Sometimes the bottom, so cloud or bottom layer ke negative charges, that negative charges having contact with the earth, on the earth materials like mountain, tree, human, etc. So earth materials, that is like a human, mountains la positive, then cloud or bottom contact panichna, that electrons will fastly transferred from bottom of the cloud to that human, even on mountain. So appo electrons transfer aagumbodhu, அது ட்ராவல் பண்ணுற பிளேஸில் காற்று இருக்கும். அந்த காற்றில் இருக்க சார்ஜஸ் எல்லாம் அதை டிஸ்சார்ஜ் பண்ணிவிட்டு, அதாவது எலக்ட்ரான்ஸை ரிமூவ் பண்ணிவிட்டு, சடனாக கீழே வரும்போது இட் ப்ரொடியூசிங் சம் சவுண்ட். இட் ஹேப்பன்ஸ் இன் வெரி ஷார்ட் இன்டர்வல். ஓகே. ஸோ தீஸ் சார்ஜஸ் ஆர் எக்ஸ்பேண்டிங் த ஏர் வென் இட் இஸ் பாசிங் ஃப்ரம் க்ளவுட் டு கிரவுண்ட். ஸோ தட் எக்ஸ்பென்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஏர் வில் கிவ் மோர் சவுண்ட் ஹியர். So even the lightning flashes, the temperature may be up to 30,000 degrees Celsius, can be reached to the ground. So it takes out all the positive charges from the human body or tree. So sometimes it dries up the tree too. Okay. So that's why the lightning and thundering are producing. Okay. So what I told, the lightning is more faster than sound. That's why we are feeling the sound is later and lightning will be at first. Okay, because of variable speed. Okay, this is about formation of lightning. And here, see, do you know, and during lightning and thunder, we should avoid standing in ground or open spaces because of the positive. So it's better to inside the metal. Okay, so inside the car or bus, if we are there, means that lightning, negative charges from the cloud won't affect our human body. So that metal will provide the shielding to us. Okay. And children, will stop our class after this, do you know? Next class will start with earthing. And today, you mark golden leaf experiment electroscope. So the answer from here, the golden leaf electroscope with the diagram. And you can study up to next page before lightning and thunder, that is end of electrical discharge up to human body. Okay, so right question, explain about the construction and working of electroscope, gold leaf electroscope. Okay, this is 5-mark question. You thorough this and write in your homework part, then you say take a photograph of this answer, then send to me to my personal WhatsApp number. Okay, thank you children.